The 7th General Meeting for the Tourism Advisory Committee saw a plethora of St. Lucia's tourism stakeholders given insight into the current standing of St. Lucia's tourism sector. Minister for Tourism, Dr. Ernest Hillaire, says coming out of a global pandemic, it is critically important for tourism industry stakeholders to be on the same page moving forward. The minister asserts that St. Lucia is poised for continued growth.
The industry has really opened up since July, and the numbers that we have seen have really been tremendous since the opening up of the industry. St. Lucia has done very well. And if you just, for example, look at the numbers for January 2022, you will notice that, you know, we almost, you know, two-thirds of where we were in 2019. Now, if you put that in context, yeah, we're almost about two-thirds of where we were in 2019. And at a time when, in January, when we still had the threat of COVID, and particularly we just saw the emergence of Omicron, if you look at the numbers for December 2021, they were phenomenal, and it just shows the strength and resilience of St. Lucia as a destination.
And the minister maintains that the challenge now is building upon St. Lucia's brand and reputation, leaving an even bigger impression on the international scene.
As the persons who are leading the industry now, we must always be cognizant of the contribution made in the past that has made St. Lucia such an attractive destination and such a resilient destination. And I never ever want to come across as boasting that we are the ones who are doing this. This is the result of hard work, you know, years of building brand St. Lucia and projecting brand St. Lucia. And even in difficult times, brand St. Lucia can still stand out as an attractive option. What we do now really is finessing brand St. Lucia and building on it to make it an even more attractive option. And that's the challenge that lies before us for the coming months and years. But from all indications, the numbers are very, very impressive.
A review of the Tourism Development Act was also on the agenda. Dr. Hillaire reveals that adjustments to the legislative framework will seek clear guidelines for tourism investment.
The key driving force behind or vision behind that new legislation will be for us to offer more support and an enabling environment for sectors other than the accommodation sector. The legislation we have now is primarily aimed at the accommodation sector, and we need to expand it because tourism is more than just, well, a friend of mine who is not here, is more than just HOTEL, hotels, but it truly is more than just the accommodation sector. Tourism is a lot more than that. And the new legislative framework will have to provide support for all the various sectors to thrive. We have to be able to identify which sectors that will be reserved for St. Lucians and which are open for international investment. We have to be able to see precisely which sectors that have been historically disadvantaged and must get more support compared to those that are probably well established.
Dr. Hillaire maintains an innovative approach is needed coming out of a global pandemic to further establish brand St. Lucia on the international circuit. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Darius.